A very good afternoon to all of you. We are here to provide you a quick briefing about the incident that happened in a chemical factory this morning. How we have structured is there are three sets of issues to talk about. We will talk about what was the incident, what is the broad impact that we know right now, what have we done from here in the central government, this response of the National Disaster Response Force, which was deployed very swiftly. And then finally, Dr. Guleria will talk about some do's and don'ts for general public that is exposed to the chemical as well as for the medical practitioners. So this morning, as you already know, there was a chemical leak in a factory about 20 kilometers from Vishakhapatnam. The gas that has leaked is called styrene. We'll tell you a little bit about what we know about the properties of this gas. It's toxic, it's injurious to human health. And so far what we know is that nine persons have lost their lives. Nearly 1,000 people were directly exposed in the close, living in the close proximity to the plant, and they have been evacuated, and a medical treatment is going on. I will hear more details shortly. Soon after that, this morning, Honorable Prime Minister chaired a meeting of the National Disaster Management Authority, which he is the chairperson of. He took situation, took stock of the situation on the ground, as well as the response that has happened so far and the response that is required from across the board. Although it is a chemical disaster, the response requires expertise on chemical side, expertise on chemical management side, as well as expertise on the medical side, expertise on evacuations and so on. So what should be the across the board response is something that Honorable Prime Minister took stock of. Right after that, the National Crisis Management Committee met in the chair of Cabinet Secretary and designed specific steps that we need to take to contain the effect. First of all, to ensure the safety of people who've been affected, but also to manage the emergency on the ground. The NDRF team, as most of you know, all NDRF teams have a minimum capacity to deal with chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear accidents. So CBRN teams of NDRF are deployed very quickly to support the local government as well as the state government. They have assisted with the evacuation of communities in the immediate vicinity. The DG NDRF will shortly talk about it. In addition to that, the central government is mobilizing specialized CBRN teams from Pune, where we have the core capacity on CBRN of NDRF located, and fly them onto the site to see what is the kind of technical support that can be provided to the plant, to the state authorities, to the local authorities as well. We are also mobilizing from the central government specialized technical support to assist the medical practitioners in the area who may not have dealt with this kind of chemical energy emergency. How do you deal with people who have exposed from the medical perspective? So basically, this is a quick overview. With that, I turn over to DG NDRF, Mr. S.N. Pradhan, to talk about the NDRF response. Thank you.
Thank you. The National Disaster Response Force, as you all know, is the first responder, the federal first responder for any kind of disaster. This was a chemical gas leak, and the incident happened, as per report, at around 2:30 a.m. in the night, previous night. Initially, the people were affected in terms of throat irritation, skin irritation, and some toxic gas smell. So the local villagers tried to contact the local administration and the local police station. And the initial movement was from the local police station, the local civic administration and the fire services. Around 5:30 or 5:45, the local NDRF unit, which is stationed in Vishakhapatnam, which is called the Regional Response Center unit, RRC unit, was informed. And the RRC unit immediately rushed and was there within half an hour. And after that, they helped in two ways. The first was for neutralizing the situation inside the polymers, LG polymer factory itself. And the second is for the evacuation of the villages, villagers near the factory site, which is the abutting village of Venkatapuram. So about 200 to 250 families were evacuated, and door-to-door search was done by the NDRF. As you all know, that the NDRF is, as the member, Mr. Kamal Kishore, said, NDRF is equipped with experts who handle chemical disasters. So this team also had experts, and those were suited up in the chemical resistant suits as well as oxygen cylinders, and they went into the premises and also door to door to recover people who may be stranded. There were some people who were unconscious or semi-conscious. There were people who were not able to move. There were children, there were women, there were people who are elders. All of them were helped, and in the process, more than 500 persons were evacuated from that area. The NDRF also has stayed back and will stay back. The unit will stay back in that area till we are absolutely sure that the situation is absolutely under control. As things stand, the reported death toll, as reported by the Andhra Pradesh authorities there, is nine dead. And there are some people who are critical, but there are most of the people who have been given first aid and relative treatment, and they are generally fine. The NDRF on its part will continue to be on the site, as I said, and it will assist the local administration till it is required. So I underline, till it is required. Additionally, as hinted by the member, an expert team of NDRF will be flying in from Pune into Vishakhapatnam. Now let me explain about this team. As I must explain that NDRF has specialized teams all across India, and some teams are more specialized than others. The chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear team, specialized team, happens to be in the 5th Battalion, Pune, of NDRF, CBRN team. So this is a chemical disaster, and that's why the commandant, Mr. Anupam Srivastav, and his team of four personnel will be flying in from Pune to assess the situation on ground and to give any assistance that is required. So as of now, things are under control. I would say that the leakage situation is much better now, in the sense that the silo that was leaking is now down to minimal, and there is hardly any leakage there. But as I say that, I also underline that we will be there till that leakage is totally plugged. And other measures to neutralize the entire chemical situation there is also being taken. So overall, the situation is under control, and I think overall we can say that now it is a question of rehabilitation and treatment of the people who have been affected. That's all from the NDRF.
From AIIMS, Dr. Gulati, please.
Namaskar. This is an unfortunate incident jo aaj subah hua Vishakhapatnam mein gas leak jo hai. This is, as has been already told, it's a compound styrene, which is an alkaline benzene compound. Agar hum is compound ki baat karein, to it can basically cause harm to humans by inhalation, by ingestion, by effect on the skin, and effect on the eyes, what we call ocular effect. Inhalation, say, it can cause mucosal irritation, irritation in the throat, in the airways, which can lead to coughing. It can lead to breathing difficulty and wheezing or whistling sound in the chest. And if the inhalation is at a higher level, it can lead to breathlessness and respiratory distress. The absorption of this compound can also lead to what we call CNS depression. That is, affects the brain, leading to headache, nausea, vomiting, weakness, fatigue, unsteadiness of gait. People get unsteady and have difficulty in walking, and sometimes fall because of that. In high exposure, it can lead to coma, pulmonary edema, and sometimes even lead to irregular heartbeat. Effect on the skin is usually mild in the form of irritation, itching, some degree of dermatitis can happen, and it can also irritate the eyes, leading to again irritation. A syndrome known as styrene sickness has also been described, which leads to nausea, vomiting, and again unsteady gait, which has been said could be inferior in a drunken, like a drunken state. There is, as far as treatment is concerned, there is no specific antidote. There is no definite medicine for reversing the effect of this compound, and treatment does remain mainly supportive. The first thing that one needs to do is remove the individuals from the affected area, and as you've heard, that has been done aggressively since early morning. Individuals, because of exposure that can happen through clothes are to be removed. The exposed eyes can be washed with water, and you can use an absorbent like tissue or towel to clean the skin so that the deposition of the skin is clean. Water can also be used. And then these individuals have to be monitored for any breathing difficulty and for any drowsiness, because like I said, it can affect the lungs, but can also affect the brain. Main treatment strategy is to watch out for any breathing difficulty and airway management. Some of these patients will require to be intubated and put on a ventilator. Many will just require oxygen therapy, and we have to monitor for their oxygen, respiratory rate, and their CNS depression. If there is bronchospasm or breathing difficulty, sometimes nebulization can also be given as far as treatment is concerned. In some, there is some data that in very sick patients, even steroids have been given when there is acute lung injury. So by and large, it tends to be an illness which is not universally fatal. In most people, there is good recovery. It causes more irritation of the airways, and depending on the degree of exposure, the effect can be much higher. So those who have had a very close exposure, they are the ones who have a higher chance of having severe effects. Currently, as has been said, that although a large number of people are admitted in the hospital, most of them are stable and should hopefully make a good recovery. Thank you.
Just one update on the deaths. The latest figure is now 10. I just got the information that 10 people have succumbed.
Friends, details coming from the spot ground will be shared with you as and when we get it. But experts are here. So any specific questions? Okay, 53.
सर मैं रविकांत हूँ न्यूज़ नेशन से सर लॉकडाउन में ये जो छूट दिया गया है उसके बाद जो
प्लीज दिस ब्रीफिंग इज ओनली फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर पर्पस जस्ट फोकस ऑन दिस
यस यस सर जो ये अनफॉर्चुनेट इंसिडेंट हुआ है आगे भी बहुत सारी फैक्ट्रियाँ ओपन होंगी तो आप लोगों की तरफ से क्या गाइडलाइंस जारी की जाएगी ताकि इस तरीके के इंसिडेंट आगे ना हों
See, on the chemical, biological, radiological, nuclear, CBRN safety, there are detailed guidelines put out by the National Disaster Management Authority. I think all of those guidelines have to be followed. Wo sari jo disha nirdesh jari kiye gaye hain ab tak, wo lagu kiye jane chahiye. Usme koi naya badlav karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Haan, jahan फैक्ट्रीज में कारखानों में प्लांट्स में लोग काम करते हैं वहाँ सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेजर्स उनके अपने ऑपरेशन के अंतर्गत किए जाने चाहिए लेकिन जहाँ तक केमिकल सेफ्टी का है सवाल है उस पर हमारे रूल्स रेगुलेशंस गाइडलाइंस बहुत क्लियर हैं उसको जैसे पहले हम रिगरसली इम्प्लीमेंट करते थे वैसे ही इंडस्ट्रीज को करने की ज़रूरत है
14
सर मेरा सवाल डॉक्टर गुलेरिया से है जो लोग वहाँ पे अस्पताल में हैं या फिर जो लोग अपने घरों में हैं क्या उनको अभी कोई विशेष हिदायत की ज़रूरत है या फिर वो निश्चिंत रहें कि अब कुछ उनको नहीं होने वाला है
तो जो लोग वहाँ पे हैं उनको तो वहाँ से विलेजेस को इवैक्यूएट कर दिया गया है और उनको मॉनिटर किया जा रहा है कि उनको एनी जैसे मैंने कहा दो मेन इफेक्ट्स है रेस्पिरेटरी और CNS उसके कोई असर तो नहीं है जो हॉस्पिटल में लोग दाखिल हुए हैं जिनको कोई सिम्टम्स हैं चाहे वो इरिटेशन ही हो चाहे वो ब्रीदिंग डिफिकल्टी हो उनको भी क्लोजली मॉनिटर किया जा रहा है एंड देर इज़ ऑल्सो हाउस टू हाउस विजिट इन दैट एरिया टू सी कि कोई किसी और जो सराउंडिंग एरियाज़ में है किसी को कोई मेडिकल प्रॉब्लम तो नहीं है। घर में एक तो एक्सपोजर आपको अंदर ही रहना, एक्सपोजर अवॉइड करना है, आउटडोर जो गैस है द गैस डजंट स्टे फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम। अगर इरिटेशन हो तो वॉश करना है अपने आँखों को, स्किन में अगर लगे इरिटेशन है तो उसको किसी टिश्यू से क्लीन कर सकते हैं, पानी से धो सकते हैं, और अगर सांस की तकलीफ हो या ड्राउजीनेस हो तो हेल्थ केयर फैसिलिटीज़ को इमीडिएटली कॉन्टैक्ट करना चाहिए।
153
Sir Polymi from India Today. My question is one about the radius of the area from where people have been evacuated. Second question is about the treatment that's going on in KG Hospital. How many are critical of those? And also initial findings are suggesting a burst in the valve which was controlling the gas over there. Probably some semi-experienced labor handled the situation, as a result of which this incident happened. Could you throw some light on that?
Well, the incident, as I said, happened at 2:30 a.m. in the night. So it was actually only the factory personnel who were there. And it's a matter of, investigation exactly what is the cause of the leakage. So that is under investigation. The local police has already started proceeding on in that direction. So we'll know that very soon, I think. But the evacuation has happened primarily in the nearby villages. Venkatpura is the first village which is most abutting the site, and then further villages were also intimated by the local administration just to be on the side of safety, and that's why those villages also were evacuated. So you could say in a radius of about 3 kilometers the people were evacuated.
116
सर, ब्रह्म प्रकाश दुबे जी न्यूज़ से। मेरा सवाल प्रोफेसर गुलेरिया जी से है। सर, जो इसका इम्पैक्ट है, जो लोग भी प्रभावित हैं, जो परेशानियां हो रही, क्या ये लॉन्ग टर्म इम्पैक्ट भी करेगा? क्या इसका किस तरह से प्रभाव देखते हैं? कहीं भोपाल गैस ट्रेजडी की तरह लॉन्ग टर्म इम्पैक्ट तो नहीं इसका रहेगा?
तो चांसेस ऑफ लॉन्ग टर्म इम्पैक्ट आर लेस, बिकॉज ये जो कंपाउंड है ये बॉडी से मेटाबोलाइज होकर जल्दी निकल जाता है। दिस इज एन एक्यूट एक्सपोजर रादर देन अ क्रॉनिक एक्सपोजर, but we will have to follow up and see. But as of now, the data doesn't suggest a significant long-term effect.
60
सर, एक छोटा सा क्लैरिफिकेशन था। प्रणय उपाध्याय हूँ एबीपी न्यूज से। कितने लोग क्रिटिकल हैं अभी आईसीयू में? कितने लोग हैं वेंटिलेटर पे? आपने कहा कि जरूरत पड़ती है कुछ लोगों को रखने की जो क्रिटिकल एक्सपोजर में हो, तो ऐसे कितने लोग हैं?
इनिशियली जो सूचना मिली थी 20 से 25 लोग क्रिटिकल हैं, लेकिन पहले सूचना थी कि वेंटिलेटर्स पर हैं, लेकिन जो विशाखापट्टनम मेडिकल कॉलेज है उसमें कोई वेंटिलेटर पर नहीं है अभी। तो ये खबर हम लोगों को अभी सुबह जो मीटिंग हुई है उसमें मिली। तो हम लोग अभी और भी हॉस्पिटल्स में अगर पेशेंट्स हैं तो उसका हम लोग पर्टिकुलरली डिटेल्स ले रहे हैं, लेकिन अभी जो सूचना है क्रिटिकल में 20-25 थे सुबह तक, बट दे वर स्टेबल।
35
और डेथ टोल अभी 11 हो गया, अभी जो लेटेस्ट मेरे को कमांडेंट ने भेजा है 11 डेथ्स।
सर, संदीप फ्रॉम न्यूज 18 इंडिया। सर, मेरा जानना था कि कितना अमाउंट ऑफ गैस जो लीकेज हुआ और कितनी देर तक ये एटमॉस्फेयर में रहेगा, कब तक ये डिसॉल्व हो पाएगा एटमॉस्फेयर में? और
देखिए, जो स्टायरीन गैस है जो मेंबर साहबान ने बताया, उसमें जो टेक्निकल प्रॉपर्टी है वो है कि इट इज़ हैवियर देन एयर, और वो पानी पड़ने पर वो नीचे आ जाता है और न्यूट्रलाइज्ड हो जाता है। तो वहाँ पर काफ़ी स्प्रेइंग ऑफ वाटर हुआ है और इसलिए वो जो उसका जो इन्फ्लेमेबिलिटी है वो काफ़ी घट गया है। दूसरी बात यह है कि जो टेक्निकल पेपर्स हमारे पास उपलब्ध हैं, ये अब देखने की बात होगी, इन्वेस्टिगेशन की बात होगी कि कितना एग्जैक्टली लीक हुआ है, हाउ मेनी किलोज ऑफ गैस, दैट इज़ अ मैटर ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन। बट ये तय है कि अब गैस का जो इंटेंसिटी है वो काफ़ी कम हो गया है। हम लोगों को ध्यान देना होगा कि लीकेज जो है 2:30 बजे रात से ही शुरू हो गया था और काफ़ी अंतराल पार हो गया है, और जो हमारे पास जो भी टेक्निकल पेपर्स उपलब्ध हैं उसमें ये दर्शाया गया है कि 6.5 से 7 घंटा इसका ज़्यादा असर रहता है। तो मुझे लगता है कि वो असर का समय काफ़ी कम हो गया है और हम लोग उम्मीद करते हैं कि आगे आगे असर और कम होता जाएगा, लेकिन हम लोग कॉन्स्टेंट वॉच कर रहे हैं। लेकिन लोगों को घबराने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, मैसेज ये है कि द सिचुएशन इज़ अंडर वॉच एंड क्लोज मॉनिटरिंग एंड वी विल बी देयर टिल एवरीथिंग इज सेफ।
लास्ट क्वेश्चन 55।
सर मैं नीरज हूँ एबीपी न्यूज़ से। मेरा सवाल है मेंबर एनडीएमए से। सर पीएम की बैठक हुई जब आज सुबह, तो पीएम ने आप लोगों को क्या निर्देश दिए, क्या बातें हुई, उनकी तरफ से क्या कहा गया?
पीएम की मीटिंग में सबसे पहले तो उन्होंने जायजा लिया कि ऑन द ग्राउंड क्या हुआ, क्या केमिकल है, उसकी क्या एंटीडोट है या नहीं है, और क्या उसके लिए बचाव कार्य में क्या काम होना चाहिए और एहतियाती तौर पे क्या काम होना चाहिए। और उसके लिए हम केंद्र सरकार की ओर से जो हमारी टीमें आंध्र प्रदेश में हैं, सिर्फ वो ही नहीं, देश के और हिस्सों से भी हम क्या रिसोर्सेज मोबिलाइज कर सकते हैं, जिससे जैसे कि डीजी एनडीआरएफ ने कहा कि जो स्टायरीन गैस है वो 6-7 घंटे तक रहती है, उसका डीकंटेमिनेशन के लिए क्या एडवाइस देनी है, वो देश के किस इंस्टीट्यूशन में उपलब्ध है, उसको कैसे जल्दी से जल्दी मोबिलाइज करके ग्राउंड पे उपलब्ध कराया जाए, इस बारे में उन्होंने दिशा निर्देश दिए और उन्हीं दिशा निर्देशों के अनुसार हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं।
थैंक यू वेरी मच फ्रेंड्स, थैंक यू।